I'd like to think that most of us living in this internet era have been guilty of late night shopping. One of my finest moments in nocturnal impulse buying was this tiny washing machine. It's ostensibly a toy, but what makes it so charming is the fact that it's a scale model of a real Miele washer. It's such a good object. The little washer has been loosely functioning as a bookend for years, but redoing my shelves recently reminded me of how precariously it serves this purpose, as it doesn't really match the heft of the books it's meant to be holding up. I figured the solution to this would be to make a concrete ballast to go inside it, which in turn would also make it even more like a genuine washing machine. I had to procure a laughably long screwdriver for the job. But once I was inside, I was off to the races. I measured up a cast for the cement, put it together, greased it up, and filled the cast up in no time. This looked like a good opportunity to expand my expertise in watching paint dry to an extension into watching cement dry. But instead, I found myself thinking that I may as well try and do something else interesting with the little washer while I had it cracked open. I bought a couple of extra smart plugs for the Christmas decorations last year and figured I could put those and some other bits and bobs to use to connect the washer to the internet and do something interesting. It was surprisingly quick to get to a point where my ancient Raspberry Pi could control the switch. The next hardest part was figuring out what input should activate it. I thought, for a few minutes at least, about activating it every time I gain a new follower on social media, but that required interacting with APIs that are well beyond my skill set. I came up with a simpler idea instead, in which anytime someone visits the pre-order for Alleycat Rally at trickart.com/ACR, the little washer will give a little spin. Once the code was figured out, it was back to the machine. After a bit of tinkering around with the circuit board, I worked out that the simplest solution for my skill set was to just wire the power directly to the motor, as the switch was handling the switching anyway. By the time I got it working and made sure it wasn't going to be driving me mad, the concrete had just about dried and it was time to break it out of its mould. I hadn't worked with concrete in this way before, and after some light sanding, I was really pleased with how sculptural the object was. The important thing was whether it fit though, and I had to chip a small notch out of it when the inevitable happened and I snapped it in half. It's no big deal. After gluing it back together, it's still nice and heavy, and with the notch chipped out, it now fits into the casing properly. I wrestled it all back together, and after the post-assembly test caught another bug in my amateur hour code, the project was finished. So there's my interpretation of a smart, internet-connected washing machine. For the sake of sanity, I've programmed it so it only checks if there have been any new visits in the past 10 minutes. And only during working hours, so it won't be spinning in the night. But if you visit my pre-order page at trickart.com/ACR, the machine will give a little spin at some point. Thanks for watching!